clearance is 100 ml per minute. Gentamicin is given 5 mg per kg. If creatinine clearance is 80 ml per minute, gentamicin is given 4 mg per kg. If creatinine clearance is 50 ml per minute, gentamicin is given 3 mg per kg. If creatinine clearance is less than 50 ml per minute, gentamicin given 2 mg per kg. The dose adjustment is 60 kg. Patient with normal renal function receives 300 mg per day of gentamicin, that is maximum 5 mg per kg per day. While 60 kg, patient with a serum creatinine level of 3 mg per deciliter would receive 100 mg per day of gentamicin. The general properties of the aminoglycosides are stable in solution. They are water soluble, more active at alkaline than at acidic pH. They have concentration depending killing property, used in divided dose, preferred once daily dose. They exhibit synergism with sale wall active beta lactams. They have significant post antibiotic effects. Aminoglycosides are bactericidal and are effective against aerobic gram-negative bacteria such as Pseudomonas enterobacter. Pseudomonas and enterobacter, this is the spectrum activity of the aminoglycosides. Aminoglycosides are used in septicemia and infections of abdomen, urinary tract, respiratory tract. Some mycobacteria, tuberculosis are susceptible to aminoglycosides, streptomycin and amikacin. Paramomycin is used against parasitic infection. Gram-positive staphylococcus aureus are sensitive to aminoglycosides, but resistance develops very rapidly, so not used for gram-positive. For staphylococcus, staphylococcal infection, endocarditis, they give synergistic effect with beta-lactam antibiotics, pain and gent, and AMP and gent. Aminoglycosides are ineffective against anaerobic bacteria, viruses, and fungi. Clinical uses of the streptomycin: mycobacterial infections as second line treatment of tuberculosis. The dose is 0.5 1 gram per day, 7.5 to 15 milligram per kg per day for children intramuscular or intravenous route. In case of non-tuberculosis infections, plague, tularema, brucellosis with tetracyclines and enterococcal endocarditis with penicillins. Clinical use of the gentamicin intramuscular or intravenous route. It is effective against both gram-positive and gram-negative organisms. The dose is 5 to 6 gram, 6 milligram per kg per day, alone or combination with beta-lactam against Pseudomonas, Proteus, Enterobacter, Klebsiella. In topical administration, creams, ointments, solutions containing 0.1 to 0.3% gentamicin for burns and wounds. Intrathecal administration for meningitis by gram-negative bacteria, 1 to 10 milligram per day. Tobramycin, similar antibacterial spectrum with gentamicin, but more active against Pseudomonas. Doses 5 to 6 milligram per kg, and route of administration intramuscular and intravenous. Natlimycin shares many characters with gentamicin and tobramycin. Due to addition of ethyl group, it is protected from enzymatic degradation. Its dose is 5 to 7 milligram per kg per day. Now, amikacin, semi-synthetic derivative of clindamycin, and is less toxic to parent parent molecule, which is resistant to many enzymes that inactivate gentamicin and tobramycin. Many gram-negative enteric bacteria, pseudomonas, and strains of multi-drug-resistant mycobacterium tuberculosis are susceptible to amikacin. The dose is 15 milligram per kg per day in intramuscular use. The neomycin, kanamycin, paramomycin active against gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria and some mycobacteria. Neomycin is too toxic for parenteral use. Use topically 1 to 5 milligram per ml, orally for bowel surgery, 1 gram every 6 to 8 hours. For hepatic coma, to reduce the ammonia intoxication, paramomycin 1 gram per 6 hourly orally intestinal amebiasis. And kanamycin can cause queror-like neuromuscular blockade and respiratory arrest. Calcium gluconate and neostigmine act as antidotes. Kanamycin can cause queror-like neuromuscular blockade and respiratory arrest. Calcium gluconate and neostigmine act as antidotes. The side effects of the aminoglycosides. All aminoglycosides are ototoxic and nephrotoxic. Loop diuretics can potentiate the nephrotoxicity. Cochlear nerve damage, tinnitus and hearing loss, vestibular damage, ataxia and vertigo. In case of allergic reactions, on topical use of neomycin and gentamicin and curare-like neuromuscular blockade. Now, precautions of the aminoglycosides. Pre-existing medical conditions such as kidney disease, 8th cranial nerve disease, myasthenia gravis, Parkinson's disease should be discussed prior to taking any aminoglycoside. Pregnant women are usually not advised aminoglycosides because they can damage to infant's hearing, kidneys, or sense of balance. Aminoglycosides not pass into the breast milk, and it is complete today's topic, aminoglycosides. Thank you very much. If any question, please send me on my email address.